When I first saw the Pentium G4560 at $64 earlier this year, I thought, gee, the Core i7-6850 is almost exactly 10 times the price. We should see if it's at all worth it. But we kind of missed the boat on that one, because the Core i9 is here now, so I mean, who would even care about this comparison anymore anyway? Wait, we'll just use its replacement, the Core i9-7820X. And we'll just agree to disagree about how many times 64 goes into 600. Synergy allows you to share your mouse and keyboard between multiple computers at once. Check it out now at the link in the video description. Let's get this out of the way right now. We are not expecting the Pentium G4560 to go toe-to-toe with the Core i9-7820X. That's stupid. I mean, for one, the Core i9 has turbo boost, to say nothing of the six extra cores that it's packing under the hood. Well, okay, Linus, then. What is the point of this video? I'm glad you asked. First, since one is roughly 10 times the cost of the other, we thought this would give us a good feel for how pricing scales with performance within Intel's product stack, because, I mean, obviously we're not gonna be getting 10 times the performance with the Core i9, right? Or will we? No, we've been through that.
That's stupid.
Reason number two is that this will give us some interesting insight into bottlenecks and where they show up within the system. For example, will the rebalanced cache and AVX512 support of the Core i9 help it? Will it hinder it? Will it depend on the workload? How much will the extra cores help with real-world tasks? Does it even really matter? Now, I know. Raw performance isn't the whole story. The Core i9 has more than double the PCI Express lanes, quad channel memory support, blah, 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 blah. And those features don't come cheap. So it makes sense that you'd be paying a premium for both the CPU and the accompanying motherboard. And because the Core i9 demands a better cooling solution, surprise, you get to buy one of those too. They even require more thermal compound thanks to their larger physical size. I mean, the Pentium comes with a cooler and compound that's more than adequate for it right out of the box. So then, with all these differences, how can we possibly compare the two? Easy. We'll just dump a bunch of benchmarks into Excel like we always do. And wait, really? Is that all I'm paying these guys for? Oh no, there's more here actually. Oh cool, okay, so while we'll be running the two chips on otherwise identical hardware, we are also going to run a second set of tests on the 7820X with it configured with only two cores enabled and clocked like a G4560. So in the past, this method of cutting down higher end chips has generated pretty accurate simulations of lower end ones. But today, the new cache setup and support for AVX512 might make things a little more interesting. Our gaming results. Well, okay, these ones aren't gonna shock anybody. Our simulated 4560 does slightly better than the real thing, and the stock 7820X blows the doors off of both in every test. But while that difference is measurable, our arch nemesis, Dr. Point of Diminishing Returns, makes a bold appearance here. Interestingly, our simulated chip actually fell slightly but measurably short of the real one at 4K in CSGO and in 3D Mark, which makes us wonder where else we might see Intel's new caching mechanism perform worse. Bottom line here, if you thought that spending 10 times was gonna net you 10 times the performance in gaming, I believe as the gamers say, get wrecked. Productivity though was really interesting. In applications like Y-Cruncher that support AVX512, we saw a massive difference with the simulated G4560, while in more traditional tasks like Cinebench, CPU Mark, and RealBench, the cache-related performance boost is less exciting, with RealBench's encoding test revealing another situation where it may actually cause a slight performance regression. It's not over for the simulated chip though, because our real-world Blender test also sees a huge performance boost over the real 4560. In productivity applications, the lack of AVX and cores hurts our value chip big time. The 7820X still doesn't give you 10 times the performance for its price, but given that many of these workloads are business-oriented ones, time is money, and even a 2x performance improvement or a more modest one could allow it to pay for itself over time, so your mileage may vary. Power consumption is probably not going to surprise anybody, so we'll skim through that, but what might is the performance scaling. Using some simple math, helpfully provided by Alex, we crunched the numbers and calculated a very theoretical ballpark for how pricing would look if it scaled linearly with performance. So in that world, from the perspective of the Core i9-7820X, the performance averaged price of the Pentium would actually be roughly 5 times as expensive as it is today. Then, looking at it the other way around, the price of the Core i9-7820X would work out to about a quarter of its current MSRP of $600. So what did we learn today? Well, first and foremost, that CPU pricing, at least for Team Blue, is more complicated than just how does it benchmark on a test bench and then what price tag should we slap on it. And more importantly, perhaps, we've also confirmed that Skylake X's new cache generally helps more than it hinders, though it can hinder situationally. There are 100 reasons for wanting multiple computers at your desk. Maybe you're a Mac person primarily, but you need a non-virtualized Windows environment for some reason. Synergy solves the problem of having to have 2 keyboards and 2 mice for 2 or more separate computers. You can share one set of peripherals so you'll no longer get confused, and the whole thing is seamless. You just drag the mouse from one screen to another. We're talking PC, Mac, and even Linux support. They offer a basic and pro option for Synergy with a one-time payment, and features include advanced stuff like clipboard sharing between computers, dragging and dropping files between computers, the ability to set up hotkeys, and more. So use our link in the video description to get 50% off Synergy today. So thanks for watching, guys. If this video sucked, you know what to do. But if it was awesome, get subscribed, hit that like button, or check out the link to where to buy the stuff we featured in the video description. Also down there is our merch store with cool shirts like this one and our community forum, which you should totally join so you can talk shop with other tech enthusiasts from around the world.